young people with tactile controllers. Cecily Morrison.
Project Torino is a physical programming language that allows children ages 7 to 11 who are blind or low vision to access the computing curriculum.
Dr. Craig Meter.
Students learn, if I take this device and plug it into this device and plug it into the hub, that creates a loop. It could be music, so they may be able to loop a couple notes together. They can create a repeat. They can add additional notes. The possibilities are endless.
Jonathan Fall.
Huge benefit of Torino is it's a physical environment. The students can actually touch and manipulate the different elements that make up the programming environment.
Each pod is a statement in your program. It's one line of code. You then put those pods together to create those lines of code in your program.
Two boys manipulate pods.
Many of these kids come in with a whole set of skills ripe for computing.
Yes. Yeah.
And we just need to give them the tools that allow them to grow that talent.
Programming is an ideal potential job opportunity for visually impaired people. They actually make up approximately 1% of the programming community worldwide.
It's either the top one or the bottom one.
It's the bottom one you need to change.
It's an environment that will work for any student that is a tactile learner. Because it's accessible, it allows you to immediately engage with the concepts of programming. It allows you to immediately create programs that work.
Khadija.
If this one was on 8 and that was on 1, this one would play because the number is higher.
Particularly in this case, where there's quite a specialized market, we needed to partner with someone who really understood that market and really understood how we would get a quite advanced technology into the hands of the kids that it would be most impactful for. APH know how to do that.
Microsoft handed us this project name of Torino, and we decided on the name CodeJumper. And they said, take all this research and time and energy and money we've spent and help us get this into the hands of students and be a partner with us.
Our hope is that we inspire all blind and low vision children to code regardless of where they are.
I think we only need 2 because then the next one there's more than one note.
Yes.
And then we put a pause in between.
Yes, that's right.
There's been lots of light bulb moments where they've suddenly understood a concept, where they've been able to track through the program physically as it's running. So they've been really enthused about Project Torino. And as a teacher, that's what you want to see in your students. You want to see that level of enthusiasm to learn more.
It's great.
It is an active, hands-on learning, hitting at those most concrete and operational levels for a student. And I think it's just the beginning of what's to come for this field.
Microsoft.